Good day, all. I want us to talk about how the banks create money in the economy. Many people have been wondering how the banks create money in the economy, how this money circulates within the economic system, how the banks play in various sectors in the economy, how do they make money available. So a lot of people have been wondering, money creation by a bank, is it possible? How do they create wealth in the economy? So I want us to look more closely on how the banks create money in the economy. Funny enough, you discover that about 98% of the money in circulation are created by the banks, while the remaining 2% are created by the government. Or some people say it's 97% or 96%. But by and large, whichever percentage you want to use, the truth is that the greater percentage of the money in circulation are created by the banks, while very little percent is created by the government. Yes, like I said, some say it's 97%, some say 98% by the banks. So banks are major players when it comes to money creation in any economy. So I want us to see how the banks create money in the economy. Now, we all know what a banking institution is. By way of simple definition, a bank is a financial institution established by law to accept deposits from the public and also to move this money from surplus end into a deficit unit by a process called financial intermediation. They play financial intermediation, transferring money from surplus end to deficit unit. And they accept deposits from the public, and also there are other special valuables which they also accept from the public. Majorly, banks are established to accept deposits from the public, and they play financial intermediation by taking money from surplus end and servicing the deficit unit. So that is primarily summarizes all the definitions we can talk about the banks. Now, of course, there are various types of bank. We have the central banks. We have the development banks, infrastructural bank, microfinance banks, community banks, regional banks, Islamic bank, World Bank, and so many types of banks. But whichever the case, these banks primarily do acceptance of deposits and then financial intermediation, moving money from surplus end to deficit units. So we've now seen what a bank is. And then the other thing we need to try to check out of definition is money. What is money? There are so many definitions of money, but primarily money is a medium of exchange. It's something you use in payment of goods and services. That's primarily what money is. So you could look at other academic definitions, but normally it's a medium of exchange. Something you use to value goods and services and use exchange in payment of those goods and services. That's what primarily what money is all about. Many of us need money. We need money to buy our clothes, we need money to buy food, we need money to pay our children's needs, service our families, we need money to travel. There's virtually no area in life or human endeavor that you don't use money. It's a medium of exchange, medium to pay for services, pay for goods. So we all know what is money. We must have used money one way or the other. Now, having known what money is and what bank is, and now the question I want us to answer is, how do banks create money in the economy? Yes, it may interest you to know that banks create, like I said earlier, the greater percentage of money we have in any economy. About 97 to 98% of money created in the system are created by banks. So how do they do it? Majorly, when a loan is given out, banks create money. That is the major way banks create money, is when they give loan. Like I said, loan comprises all the categories of advances, be it overdrafts, be it letters of credit, be it bill of exchange, be it term loan, or whatever name it goes by. Whenever there's a loan is a kind of a broad name or the collective name we use for all those advances. So whenever a bank creates loan, where they give out loan to customers through their accounts, their various accounts, they have created money. They take, for instance, assuming a customer requests for $2 million and banks have, like, let's say $10 million. Now, they take this $2 million, pay into the person's account. They take other ones they have, pay into, assuming there are several customers that need money, $2 million, $1 million, $500,000, and the rest of them. They use their loanable funds from their capital adequacy and all that, and begin to distribute in various accounts. These customers take this money, do business with it, return the money into the system. They must have made profit from the business, supposedly, and they take this profit for their personal use and for their business use. They return the capital, of course, plus the interest to the banking system. Now, whenever other forms of customer come, they take available funds and distribute. So, bank can give to as many as 100 customers from the capital which they have. And of course, before they loan out funds, they must have obeyed the financial regulations. Like, look at capital adequacy, look at liquidity ratios, obey the CRR, cash reserve ratios of various regulatory bodies that are regulating the system. You must have taken care of the CRR, cash reserve ratio, you must have taken care of liquidity, you must have taken care of the capital adequacy ratio. So because it's from these ratios that you use to know how much you can loan out to customers. And once this money is loaned out, they loan to various customers, and pay this money to their various accounts. The customers take this money, do business with it, and return the money. So you can see that with deposits which are sent from the public, they give out this money to several hours. Let me assume one customer pays like $50 million into the account. And then they're supposed to loan out like say $10 million. They could give like 10 customers for $1 million each. You could see how many people they have given out, they've made money, they've created 10 different customers by giving them $1 million each, but it was a deposit from one customer. So you could see how banks create money in the economy. They collect this deposit from the public, they give it to so many customers that need it and who have fulfilled their conditions, predestined to draw down. So you see how banks create money in the economy by when they give out loans from various accounts. It sounds funny, but it is true. And also, it sounds funny to know that 97 to 98% of the money in circulation was created by the bank. Why government plays little role through their various central banks or any other name that the banks go with? Play like 2% or 3%. So when a deposit is made into an account, loan is created. Money is created. When the bank pays money into the customer's account, whether it's a current account, whether it's a savings account, whether it's a hybrid account, they've created a loan, especially when the customer uses the money to do business. They have created a loan. You can imagine how many banks we have all over the world. You can imagine how many customers they have. You can imagine how many customers they are financing their loan requirement. You can imagine how much they have created. So new loans, new debts, and they are making new customers. And these customers also help to circulate this money because they take this money outside the banking system, do business, make profit, and later they use whatever profit they have made to establish other businesses. They throw the money back into the banking system. The bank also accepts these deposits, give it to other customers that equally need the money. You could see how banks create money in the system. So money is created out of nothing by banks. From those deposits which they collect from customers, they give out loans through the various accounts of various customers, and by so doing, money is created. So there's a need for people to pay attention to loan repayment, that debt repayment. When they give you this money, don't forget that this money was deposited by some customers. And if you take this money and you don't return it, it's going to create some financial losses into the system. And you're also not helping the bank to create more money. So when they give some customers money and they don't return the money into the system, it's affecting money creation. So yes, banks create money. So you need to equally encourage the banks to create more money so they create more millionaires, more billionaires, more rich men into the society. But primarily, The major way they create this money is through loan. When they give you loan from your various accounts, from various customers' accounts, money is created. So they accept deposit from the public, and from that is surplus end now, and give to deficit need from people who need this loan for various business activities, or even some personal activities. And then when they return this money, the bank will accept this money again and use it to create more loans. So there's a need for people to pay attention to debt repayment. Whenever a bank gives you a loan, try and return it, because if you don't return it, you're affecting their capacity to create more money into the system. Because major way they create money is through disbursement of loan to various customers' accounts. So we have seen how the banks create money. It sounds funny, but this is primarily the way which banks give out money. And like I said, 97 to 98% of the money in circulation is created by banks, while 2 to 3% is only created by the government. So let us help the bank in creating more money, creating more millionaires. Because by the time they give you money, it's expected that you use it and do business, make profits, expand your business horizon, your business scope, and then you satisfy yourself, satisfy your dreams, satisfy your business need and your family needs, and also your personal ambitions and dreams. So let us also put the bank system in mind whenever they give us loans in one way or the other. Think of how to repay these loans so that it will enable them to create more money and create more millionaires into the system. So thank you for listening to me, and I would like you to subscribe to my channel so that you see other details of how banks impact on the lives of people and the lives of their businesses. Thank you for your time, and I hope to see you again.